Hyaenodon would have little chance defending a carcass against a bear dog.
When you look at a large hyaenodon like this one here, it is nowhere near as big as the biggest of these bear dogs. This big bear dog here is almost certainly capable of beating any hyaenodon in a head-to-head battle.
When it came to hunting, bear dogs quickly established their dominance.
It's a much more sophisticated animal than any hyaenodon, plus the fact that of a large size like this and a long stride length, this animal could have certainly covered ground a lot faster than the hyaenodon. This animal was able to kill just about everything that lived in its time.
Bear dogs were killing an abundance of prey, taking the food right out of Hyaenodon's mouth. The best Hyaenodon could hope for was to scavenge a few scraps after the bear dogs had finished eating. And this wouldn't have sustained its existence.
We have something called the competitive exclusion principle, and it says that two species can't occupy the same ecologic niche at the same time. It's like having two McDonald's right next to one another on a street. They're only going to be drawing from the same customer base, and either they're going to have to merge or go out of business.
As the bear dog population increased, it was the final nail in Hyaenodon's coffin.
Hyaenodons went extinct right about the time these huge bear dogs appeared, so I think it's reasonable that these large, modernized, very fast, very effective predators drove Hyaenodons to extinction.